And while the Trump agenda saw a lot of progress this week, the deep state continued to collapse, and Deputy AG Rod Rosenstein was in the hot seat. Take a look at this.
Why are you keeping information from Congress?
Congressman, I am not keeping any information from Congress.
And I want to know why you won't give us what we've asked for.
Sir, I certainly hope that your colleagues are not under that impression. That is not accurate, sir.
And it is accurate. We have caught you hiding
information. Mr. Chairman, can we allow? You wrote the memo saying that Comey should be fired, and you signed the FISA extension for Carter Page. So my question is to you, seems like you should be recused from this more so than Jeff Sessions.
Congressman, I can assure you that if it were appropriate for me to recuse, I'd be more than happy to do so and let somebody else handle this.
Did you not know that Bruce Orr was meeting with Christopher Steele, getting the information about the dossier and supplying that information to the FBI? At the same time, his wife Nellie was working for Fusion GPS that was helping Hillary Clinton. Did you not know he was doing that for the FBI?
Whatever you got, finish it the hell up, because this country is being torn apart.
Joining us now are two of the men you just saw, Florida Congressman and gubernatorial candidate Ron DeSantis and Texas Congressman Louie Gohmert. All right, gentlemen, good to have you here. I'm going to start with you, Representative Ron DeSantis. Was our favorite guy, Rod Rosenstein. I got to tell you, I watched that congressman, and I was just so frustrated with the smirking and the don't attack me personally and the taking the time to run the clock. But is he keeping information from Congress?
Judge, this is really concerning because it's, yes, they're keeping information from Congress, but it's not just a normal stonewall. What they're saying is Peter Strzok opens this massive counterintelligence investigation against Trump's campaign. We obviously know that was colored with bias. We know all the problems. But when we're trying to get all the details about it, Rosenstein will say, I just can't talk about it. It's classified. It's sensitive. Peter Strzok, when he was in front of Judiciary on Wednesday for his deposition, he wouldn't answer most of the questions because it's classified. So they unleash the counterintelligence powers of the government, and now they're using that, the sensitivity of that, as a shield to protect them from congressional oversight. That is wrong.
Well, it's clearly wrong. And Congressman Gohmert, I mean, you think that these guys are actually listening in on your office?
Well, I don't know about listening in, but I've been told that they're keeping an eye on me. And the thing is, though, I mean, look at what they do. They have a history, and especially Mueller and Weissman, they work together on the Russia investigation where Russia is trying to get our uranium illegally, which they have done. And so that was also under the jurisdiction of a guy named Rosenstein.
Right.
Rosenstein, Mueller, Comey, Weissman, they are joined together on so much of this stuff.
Well,
and yet it is incredible. And Judge, you know, you've seen people lie. I can't say what all Strzok said, but during the hours I was watching, you know, you would see him say things that he knew he was lying. He knew you knew he was lying.
Interesting.
And yet he was so cool about the way he would say it. And I was sitting there going, golly, he's so good about lying. And then I realized, oh, you know what? He's been doing that forever to his wife. He's got this lying with the proper emotion down pat. All those times he probably lied to his wife about Lisa Page. This guy's really good at what he does. And then Rosenstein, to sit there and say he didn't know what the guy in the office two doors down who worked directly for him, he says he was not working on the Russia investigation. Oh, I didn't know he's the one that got the information from Christopher Steele for the FBI. Wow.
Well, and you know, Congressman,
I mean, holy cow.
Yeah, I know. You know what, Congressman Gohmert, I share your frustrations. But Congressman DeSantis, I'm going to ask you this, and the American people understand what's going on. You look at this guy, Rod Rosenstein. He's so knee deep in the swamp, it's pathetic. He's the one who's said that Comey should be fired. He's the one who convinced Sessions that he should recuse himself. He's basically now running the Department of Justice. He says he doesn't know anything and he's not dragging his feet on the production of records that Congress wants. But the American people instinctively understood this because they elected an outsider to be president. So here's the question that they have. What are you going to do about it? I don't want to hear it's the conscience of the Senate or of the Congress. We want you to hand it over. What are you guys going to do about this? When are we going to see justice?
Well, you have to impose a sanction for noncompliance. I've been saying we should have done that months ago, Judge, because we've been doing this dance back and forth,
right.
And it's just counterproductive. It just wastes time. I don't know, though, so that's what I would like to do personally. I do have other colleagues who would. I don't know whether we have a majority of the Congress who would support that at this juncture. I hope we do, but ultimately you would need to vote it out through the whole body, but I think that's absolutely appropriate. And if you don't do a sanction, then they're going to keep stonewalling.
Of course they're going to stonewall. This is the same people who said to you there were no emails between the FBI and the Department of Justice on the meeting on the tarmac between Loretta Lynch and Bill Clinton. Come on, they've been lying, you know, from the get-go on this whole thing. But I'm going to go back to you, Congress.
It's all going to be a question of how strong our leadership is. When Boehner was Speaker, he would not let us go after Koskinen. The guy lied. It was just all kinds of offenses were committed. Loretta Lynch, there were problems there. But you had the IRS knee-deep in lies and fraudulent conduct, and he wouldn't let us do anything. But if you remember, Trey finally got the assurance, and that's why he went on Sunday shows previous 2 weeks ago and said, we are going to have a vote this week if he doesn't produce this week. And we didn't have a vote that week because it got pulled back yet again.
By
our
whom?
Leadership
by
has
whom? Give me a name.
A
stop saying leadership. Give me a name.
Well, they're elected. They're not leaders, but they've been elected. And they have prevented us from keeping these guys or making them accountable.
Give me
so
a name. Who are we talking about? Paul Ryan? Who are we talking about? Paul Ryan?
That's where the buck stops. Yes.
Thank you very much. Congressman Ron DeSantis, you were great last night. Congressman Louie Cromer, thanks so much for being with us.